Hey Nordies, our phones carry a large part of our sensitive data, and Android is one of the most popular operating systems we use. In this video, we're going to learn how to improve Android security and how to make your small green robot happy. But before we move on, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and be the first to get all our newest content. Now, let's get back to Android security. While Android is relatively secure, it's a bit easier target for hackers than iOS. Also, Android banking malware grew by 35% in 2020, so there's quite a few major reasons to treat your security seriously. Here are 8 steps that we recommend you take to stay safer on Android. Number 1. Turn on the Find My Device feature. This feature enables you to track your device, lock the screen, or wipe its data if you lose it. Android usually has it enabled by default, but we recommend double-checking it to see if it's on. Just go to Settings, tap on Biometrics and Security, and turn on the Find My Device option. Also, you have to turn on your location for it to work. Number 2. Always lock your screen. Make sure that you have your screen lock on. Just avoid using weak passwords such as 0000 or 1234. Use strong and complex passwords or a fingerprint lock instead. Android also has a smart lock feature which automatically unlocks if you're in a secure environment like your home, but we don't recommend it if you want to max security. Number 3. Activate lockdown mode. Lockdown mode blocks all your smart lock features, such as your fingerprint, and demands your PIN, password, or pattern to log in. This function may be useful if someone tries to forcefully unlock your phone by using your face or fingerprint when you're asleep, unconscious, or unaware. A PIN is always safer as it requires your conscious consent. To enable lockdown mode, choose Lock Screen in the Settings menu, then tap on Secure Lock Settings, and toggle on Show Lockdown option. To activate this mode, hold down the power button and tap on the lockdown mode icon. Number 4. Enable two-factor authentication. Two-factor authentication is an additional layer of security. On top of your password, it will ask you for a security code or other info, so it'll protect you even if someone hacks your primary password or PIN. We recommend enabling two-factor authentication for every app. So here's how to enable it on your phone. First, go to your device settings, then tap Google and pick Manage Your Google Account. Then tap on Security and find two-step verification. Now sign into your Google account, click Get Started, and follow the steps on the screen. Number 5. Always check app permissions. Apps usually ask your permission to access various features on your phone, and we usually approve them without much questioning, sometimes allowing suspicious apps to track and even collect our sensitive data. We strongly recommend that you review your app permission list and disable those that you think are suspicious or not essential. To do this, go to Settings and tap on Apps, select Permissions, then select a permission and see which applications have it. Toggle off all the permissions that you feel are unnecessary or suspicious. Alternatively, you can just open an app in the permission list and then disable permissions there. Also, always research every app that you download, read the reviews or customer feedback, and avoid downloading apps from dodgy sources. Number 6. Enable Google Play Protect. Play Protect scans apps for malware or suspicious activity. It also scans the apps installed on your phone, and you can decide whether you want to keep or delete them. To enable this feature, open the Play Store app, tap the 3 horizontal lines or dots, and choose Play Protect. Number 7. Use a VPN. When you're out and about with your phone, you usually use public Wi-Fi, which is often not well protected. VPN encrypts your traffic, so you no longer need to worry about the safety of the networks that you're now connecting to. NordVPN is definitely the best option for you. It's simple, it's easy to use, it's super safe, and super fast. Get it here. Number 8. Turn off your Wi-Fi and Bluetooth when not in use. When Bluetooth is on, your device is always looking for connections, which may pose potential risks as criminals can take over your device by using Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. And that's it. We hope these tips will make you a happy and safer Android user. Before we wrap it up, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and share your very own Android safety experience in the comment section down below. Stay safe. Liked our video? You may also like this one. Check it out here.